financial instability and the middle class of South Africa, drawn from the first four waves of the National Income Dynamics Study. The first four waves of NIDS data have shown that many South Africans were stuck in poverty between 2008 and 2015. NIDS also shows that the path from poverty is full of advances and setbacks, and that South Africa has a lot of people falling into and out of poverty. These frequent shifts into and out of poverty make for uncertainty in the lives of many South Africans. So where does the middle class fit into all of this? One school of thought is that the solution to inequality lies in a growing middle class. They buy goods and services that need to be made and delivered. This creates jobs to make and deliver them. People in these new jobs join the middle class and buy goods and services. And so the wheel keeps turning. Money changes hands, jobs are created, and inequality falls. But to have the confidence to buy things, we need to feel that tomorrow will not bring disaster. And we have seen that life is uncertain for many. So who do we regard as free from uncertainty? Here, we identify people who have an above average chance of not falling into poverty in the next 2 years. This gives us just under a quarter of South Africans. Given the high levels of inequality in South Africa, the top 4% within this group are wealthy enough to be regarded as elite, with close to zero chance of ever becoming poor. This leaves us with just 20% of South Africans being middle class, where they have enough income and assets to not be poor, and a small but not impossible chance of becoming poor. This is a much smaller number than what is presented in many articles in newspapers and online. This means that they represent a much smaller economic driver than many have hoped for. As for the other three quarters of South Africans, they fall into those who are above the poverty line but still vulnerable to becoming poor at any time, the transient poor, who have an above average chance of getting out of poverty but remain vulnerable to falling back into it, and the chronically poor, who have little chance of getting out of poverty. Looking at those people in the middle class in the NIDS data, what makes them different from those who are poor and vulnerable? Well, they are more likely to have household heads with higher levels of education, have smaller households, and be located mainly in urban areas. In addition, there has been rapid growth in the African share of the middle class, although Africans are still underrepresented compared to the total population. The vulnerable and those dropping in and out of poverty will need different help to the 49% who are chronically poor. The high levels of poverty and inequality in South Africa make choosing the mid-range of incomes unsuitable for defining a middle class. Additionally, the middle class does not start where poverty ends. The chances of falling back into poverty are too high for many above the poverty line. To define an economy-driving middle class in South Africa, we must look for those with some hope of stability. Certain things can assist entry into the stable, economy-driving, and inequality-reducing middle class, such as improving access to quality higher and tertiary education, and trying to balance the rapid creation of flexible jobs, which leave people vulnerable, with the slower creation of stable jobs, which leave people able to live their lives free of uncertainty. This video was drawn from the National Income Dynamics Study, which is an initiative of the Department of Planning, Monitoring and Evaluation. The study has been following the lives of 28,000 South Africans since 2008, and in so doing has been collecting a huge amount of data every 2 years. It's designed to help facilitate the development of better policy informed by better research. It's available and it's free. Find us at www.nids.uct.ac.za. The National Income Dynamics Study, telling the stories of the people of South Africa.